Welcome back. Let's play some more Puggsy. Last time we had just defeated the Redwoods and opened up Redwood Keep. I guess it's still technically part of the Redwoods since we haven't fought a boss yet. But let's get going. Okay, first thing we have is a hint box. Open it up. Looks like there's some sort of 10-pound weight. And some blue thing. I did a little bit of off-screening so I can get my speed boots again. That's the only off-screening that I'll do for these videos because I know you don't want to see me trudge back to the treasure cove every single time I get hit. This weight doesn't make a very good weapon. It's hard to throw. Different items have different physical properties in this game. It's one of the cool things about it. Okay, what's this wait for? Well, there's an area coming up here that we can't get past because we're too light. That fan keeps blowing us back. However, once we have the wait, we can get past there no problem. We won't be needing that anymore. Hey, beach balls. Cool. Need one of those. Fall down here. Okay, those fans will blow that beach ball upwards. Whoa, the heck are those? Some sort of rocking horse or something it looks like. There's that blue thing that we saw in the hint box. We'll be getting into that in just a little bit. And it looks like one of those foxes up there has a key. So, we need to murder him, and then wait for that other fox to nudge the key over close enough to where we can grab onto it. One more nudge ought to do it. This isn't a normal puzzle for this level. This is a puzzle to access yet another secret door. We need to flip that switch, and that means we can stand where that stone used to be. Why would we want to stand there, you ask? Well, let's stack these items on top of each other, and then... Oh, it's a balloon! It'll take us about 45 to 60 seconds to float up there. Maybe a little less. That was some good music. We move even a little bit, that key will fall off and we won't be able to access that secret door. Let's hope this works. Yep. Let go of that balloon, and we just open up another secret level. A secret tunnel, as a matter of fact. Sounds secret. Okay, this puzzle's a little bit tricky. There's three switches up on top here, and three switches down below, which we can see when we use this little remote control doohickey. Okay, let's see, let's follow the arrow to see where the exit is. Okay, it's up from here, so let's go back up. Okay, well, obviously we need to go this way, but there's a block in the way. Let's see what happens when we switch those switches. Flip those switches. Okay, all three of them are unflipped. We need all three of them to be flipped. Oh, I'm a little rusty, so this might take me a while. And that looks about right. Okay, let's go see if we can get past that stone now. There's a bridge in there that wasn't there before, but that stone's still there. Well, let's see what else this level has. It's another switch. Okay, well, we'll go ahead and leave our remote control there, since we won't be needing that anymore. Alright, now we can get through there, no problem. That exit takes us to the lighthouse. This is where the game stops being quite so linear. I think we can actually skip a few levels if we go this way, but of course I want to play all the levels, just because I can. It's dark in here. Let's go ahead and open this lock. Whoa, it's like a whole freaking shoe carnival in here. Let's build a stack so we can get to whatever's up there. Stack building is a useful skill to have in this game. Okay, let's kill this. Oh, pelican. Well, that took care of him. We have a seashell, an apple, another seashell, and a rubber ducky. Is that it? None of that stuff seems very useful, does it? Well, let's get some more shoes. And let's see what's up here. That's where the arrow's pointing, so that must be where the exit is, right? Oops. Oh well, plenty more where that came from. Let's bring an item with us this time so we have something to kill these enemies with, since they're bouncing a little too erratically to jump on them. Alright, and that must be the exit. But we're not going to go that way. We're going to grab this flashlight. Come down here. Okay, let's see what we can see. Oh, rubber ducky. You're the one who makes bath time lots of fun. One of these pots. Oh yeah, there it is. That looks almost like a seashell, doesn't it? Well, let's see what happens when we put a seashell in there. Is this the right one? Yep. Opens up a shaft. And another secret door. Alright, and that opens up the exit to a hidden place. Ooh, sounds nice. Well, we'll get there in the next update. Let's go ahead and save our game here. Alright, tune in next time when we explore a hidden place and more of Puggsy. Until then, I'm Asherin. See you later.